Hello everyone, welcome to EduTab. And today we have Mr. Balaji with us in our success story series. And recently he has cleared FCI AGM 2021 examination. So today we will know about what strategies did he follow for the examination, what were his learnings, and what he suggests for the future aspirants for the same examination. So we all welcome Mr. Balaji to EduTab. Hello sir, how are you?
I'm good, ma'am. Thank you so much.
So, how do you feel finally getting into the job?
It was kind of relief. It was smooth.
So, sir, before understanding your strategies, how you prepared for the examination, we would like to know about your education qualification. So, about that, and also how you ended up to preparing for FCI.
Yeah, ma'am. I did my MBA from IIM Trichy in 2019. Thereafter, I started working with a edutech company for a couple of months. I was interested to work in BFSI sector, so I moved to Bajaj Housing Finance. Then I worked for 1 year there. Later, my interest was more into this regulatory body exams, so I started preparing for that. I saw a good opportunity in FCI AGM with PG being the qualification for the exam. I thought this would be the better opportunity. So I prepared from EduTab from there. Somehow it went well.
Right. So, sir, as you said that you were preparing for regulatory bodies and you have appeared for RBI and NABARD also. Yes. So, sir, because there was you were preparing for so many examination and for due to one reason or another, you could not get into the final merit list. So, sir, what kept you motivated to still go ahead and then going for another examination with same efforts, with same hard work? Because a person, he feels demotivated when he could not achieve what he is desiring for. So what was that motivation?
It was more of in all the exams, I was going till the last step, but somehow I was not reaching the final list. So just that idea of almost reaching the final step, it pushed me to prepare more and go for other exams.
Yes, sir, because every time you were in that, yes, sir.
Moreover, my friends who already cracked the exams, they are looking at their lifestyle and their way of living. It just motivated me better.
Right. Because every time you went to till the final step, so that kept you motivated that, yes, you can do this. Because if you have reached this far, you can definitely can cross that particular line, that barrier, which was there. And yes, of course, the good peer pressure is really healthy for us. So looking at them, the lifestyle now they have, that kept you motivated for the thing. All right. So, sir, we would want to know about the strategies and also about the sources that you followed for the different section. So, sir, we'll start with numerical ability and reasoning, and then one by one we'll go for every section. So, sir, what was your strategy for numeric ability and reasoning?
It was more of easy section for me because I already prepared for CAT after my graduation, and I got a very good percentile. So it was, and then I prepared for a couple of regulatory body exams also. So it was more of, there was not much need of practice for me there. And I just went with the mock test, nothing else other than that. As I already prepared for that section, it doesn't require much effort for me there. So it was, and the questions were pretty easy in the exam. It was just any other banking exam. So okay. It actually helped me to increase my score in exam.
Right. So means numerical ability and reasoning, the questions, they were much of the banking type. So basically arithmetic questions.
It was, every question was of banking type.
Yeah. So that's why you preferred mock test, because in mock test, it gives you a complete revision of every chapter. Right. And that too in that particular format in which the examination asks. So that was for the numeric ability. Next comes GA. Because you're from BTech background and you prepare for CAT, so maths is something that we can pretty much assume that you are good at. But this GA portion, because that is completely different from what your background is for education. So how did you manage that? That too, and current affairs also.
Yes, particularly for GA, it was kind of a doubtful area for me in exam also. I guess I scored less in compared to other sections in GA only. But I, like, my preparation was more of preparing for the last 3 months. And as union budget and economic survey is more important, I prepared for like those sections also. But in exam, they asked like a couple of questions from last 6 months too. In this particular, like in generally regulatory body phase one exams, they concentrate more on 3 or 4 months. So I was in thinking about in that way and prepared for only 3-4 months. But in this exam, they asked mostly from 6 months. There I missed a couple of questions. But I think right strategy would be to prepare for 6 months.
The current affairs of 6 months.
Yes.
Right. So what kind of questions were there? Because you haven't prepared much. So, but yes, still you can analyze that. Were they asked in-depth questions or they were just surface type of questions?
Yeah, some questions, they those are meant not to be answered. Like some 4 or 5 questions were there, pretty difficult, like which no one can answer. And some questions came from schemes too. Those questions like helped me because I already prepared for other exams. So schemes questions I was able to answer. And some questions were from like, most of the questions are not from scratch. They are like in depth only. The difficult part is GA section in this exam. Like remaining were comparatively easy.
Yes, because GA is so vast and anything can be asked from that.
Correct.
Right. And so one more thing for current affairs only, as you said that schemes were there and budget questions from budget. So in FCI examination, were questions asked specifically on how much budget was allocated for a particular scheme? Or
nothing that specifically, but most important schemes like PM Kisan, PM Asha, this type of questions, like mostly related to agriculture.
Right. So this was for GA and CA. And next we'll come to management and ethics.
Yes.
So yeah, so because you have management background, so maybe that have helped you. But still, what do you suggest to the aspirants that how can they prepare if there are some good books or sources that you could tell?
My preparation is strictly it's in EduTap only. I stick to EduTap. I didn't like read from any other books because I already read for RBI. It was the same syllabus for management. So I stick to EduTap, and good thing happened in exam. Like there were a couple of very difficult questions, which like some other source won't cover, but EduTap somehow like covered like vast material, which generally people think it's not ideal to read, but it helped in exam. Like there were a couple of theories which no one could answer, but I read it fully, so it helped me in the exam, especially in management.
Right, because most of the people, they want precise material, but sometimes having a wider scope, that would help you.
A couple of 4 or 5 questions like from very small theories, which generally people won't read, but it was there in exam.
Right. So means if a person has given or economist have given some theory, so that was also asked about that. Who has given that particular kind of theory? Right.
No. Questions related to theory. I mean, content.
Something content that what is this theory about? Questions like that.
Yeah.
All right.
Yes.
So means theories have a good weightage in examination. Yes, because if 2 or 3 questions are there, that is a good weightage.
Yes. And ethics also, like it was equal proportions. I was expecting management to be dominating in the exam, but it was almost 50-50, I guess. Ethics also, there was a lot of questions. And ethics was very new to me. I mean, it was more of UPSC syllabus. It's related to UPSC syllabus.
Okay.
So I just referred some other books, but then I didn't find it useful to retention. Then I stick to EduTap again. I started reading from there on that material only, and somehow it went well in ethics part also.
So because you are from a management background, so you would be able to tell us that the questions of management in examination, were they in depth as compared to what you were taught 2 years, or were they just basic questions that people can answer if they study?
It was in depth, ma'am. Especially ethics part. They made sure that it like very small questions were like in-depth questions were asked in exam. and some of the questions were like concentrated on one very, very specific topics. There was a huge syllabus, but they concentrated only on particular area only. So questions were there from only specific areas.
All right. So, sir, what about agriculture and agriculture economy and computer?
Yeah, agriculture, as last year I went for interview to NABARD. My preparation was more or less done there. Then questions were mostly asked from current affairs part, and there was no in-depth questions from
static agriculture. Question.
Yeah, mostly it was very basic questions, more about soils, what kind of soils, this type of questions were asked, but there was no in-depth questions. Some questions were asked, which like difficult to answer for anyone. So we need not work, like we did not think much about those questions. So.
Right. So do not waste time on something that you know that you cannot even guess that.
Yes. Ma'am.
Yeah. So, but one thing was good there that as there was no negative marking.
Yes.
Yeah. So you can at least make a guess.
Yes.
Yeah. So, sir, this was about your written preparation for the mains. And then now next, let's come to the interview. So, yes, sir, some people say that the panelists, they are very strict and they are not friendly to you. Some say they are very supportive. So what your experience is about it?
My experience is more like I didn't expect any of the questions they asked in it. Like, I prepared fully about FCA and what their functions and like kind of my background also. But they came up with questions which I didn't expect at all. So it was a tough. But good thing is it's just 10% weightage.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
So, weren't there questions about the biodata that you have given to them about the background?
They asked, but by the time I entered, one of the panelists went outside. That also kind of felt bad for me, like why she's not sitting.
Because you had to sit there.
Yes. She suddenly left before me entering the room. Then there were six people in front of us. In general, there will be 3-4. So I was like, I know that there are 6 people, but then looking at them sitting there, they are not. They seem that they are not interested. That too at lunch hour. By their expressions, I felt that they were acting. But I guess they were interested, but they were acting like that.
Yeah.
He started me asking, why did you leave your job? Like first question is that. Then I was expecting some simpler questions in the start.
Right.
That made me a little nervous there. But
right. So you cannot really predict what the questions can be. The
questions were pretty upbeat. They suddenly asked me, why didn't you prepare for UPSC? Why are you coming to FCA? No, it's like they didn't ask me why are you coming for FCA. They started asking me what all other exams you prepared. Why didn't you prepare for UPSC? Tell me about NABARD. I was not expecting they'll ask about NABARD. I was expecting
they would ask about FCA, right?
Yeah.
So means if you are prepared for some other examination, not only for the examination you are appearing for the interview, but you should know about all the examination that you have given.
Yeah, but they didn't ask me in depth. They just asked me NABARD functions. Tell me about why NABARD is established.
Right.
But I was not expecting that question.
Right.
I read fully for NABARD interview, but then at that time I felt a little nervous because I was not expecting it.
Right. Yes. Okay.
And so, only 2-3 people asked me questions. So I was expecting everyone to ask at least one question.
So it was kind of confusing state at that time.
Yes. And then they asked me to leave within some 10 to 15 minutes only. Very less number of questions. I don't know what they understood from those questions. So I was in a kind of confusion that what happened.
So sir, in exam, in interview also, some technical questions are asked or it's just
fully background? Depending upon my background. Nothing. They asked me about my work, like what did I do in Bajaj Housing Finance.
Right.
Then they asked me, why did you leave? They asked me a little about company.
Right. So it was all about your daily lifestyle that you had. And yeah, it was not on the questions, on some agriculture technical questions, they were
Nothing about us. Chairman asked me only one question, like, as of now, FCI is not profitable because we are not doing anything of profit. But just tell me one thing, what would be our real asset if we want to make it profitable? I was thinking of telling about employees and all, but he asked me what is shown in balance sheet, tell me that. Then I was telling about warehouses and all, but he doesn't seem to be interested about it. Some other answer.
Right, so like if they can throw any question on you. Even before being the manager, they can ask you to act like that. Yeah. So Balaji sir says that for numeric ability, it's best if you go for mock test because you would have a wholesome revision of every chapter and you would know what kind of questions can be asked from that. He also tells us about the level of the questions. They are just as any other bank examination, that is the arithmetic level of maths. Then we'll come for, when coming for GA, he says it's a vast area to cover. And for current affairs, he says it is best if you go for last 6 months because questions can be asked from that and they have been asked from that particular section. For management and ethics, he had a management background, but then he took course from EDUTAP also. But in general, he said that level was somewhat of what is asked in UPSC. So, and weightage was 50-50. He was expecting that management weightage could be more, but the weightage, it was 50-50. And then for agriculture, because he had prepared for the NAMARD, so he could say that it was kind of easier for him to revise. But for that, he says that agriculture, current affairs were more than the static portion. And the static portion was not that deep. He says it was more of the in general questions all of soil that one can answer if they have a little bit overview of agriculture. So am I missing anything, sir?
Or no, nothing. You covered almost all the points.
Yeah. So sir, one thing last that you want to say all to the aspirants, that how to prepare and whatever you want to say to them.
Yeah, like after like resigning from the job, it was very tough for me because I was not interested to move into the same role again. I was working in sales in Bajaj Housing Finance. So I was not interested to move again into similar kind of roles. I gave myself 1 year to prepare for like any competitive exams. After that, I thought of again moving back if nothing goes good. Like we all think of like letting it at some point. I was about to, but somehow it just went well and finally landed up here.
Right. So it's just about the continuous efforts that even though you do not achieve what you desire, but if you are continuous with it, you will achieve something that is more or less related to what you wanted, the lifestyle that you imagined. So that's very beautiful what you have said. So that is all for today. Thank you, sir, for joining us, for sharing your experience. Thank you so much, sir.